What is going on, lads, and welcome to a team of arch rivals. Today, we are going to be taking a look at players who absolutely hate each other or hate each other as much as you possibly could over a game of football, and then some of them where it is just on another fucking level. This was very, very requested on my best friend's video. I think the first guy to post it was a guy called Garibay18, so massive thank you to you, mate, if you are watching this video as well. Thanks for this absolutely awesome suggestion. And we are basically going to get straight into this squad. You guys seem to absolutely love the best friends one as well. I think we smashed like 2,000 likes at the time of recording this one. So if you could do that again, if we could do 2,000, that would be absolutely unbelievable. Your guys' support recently has been insane. But let's just jump into this squad again. Very quickly, as I always say to you guys, there's a link down in the description to IG Sky if you want to go and get yourself any coins. They are ridiculously cheap, like the cheapest place on the internet that is 100% reliable to go and get you your coins. You guys always say, is it actually reliable because it's so cheap? Honestly, lads, I've bought millions from them. The discount code AJ3 gets you 5% off, and you can go and stock up before Team of the Year, before the prices start to creep back up as the demand for coins really does go through the roof. So go and get them now while they are absolutely crazy cheap. And let's put in someone in goal, actually. Usually we don't have these because it's 11 men in a squad, and we usually do pairs of people, like pairs of brothers or pairs of best friends. In this case, we're doing pairs of arch rivals. But there is one guy that has got quite a lot of enemies and has had quite a lot of bust-ups of people in his time in football. So we're going to put in Chiellini in goal. And then over at left back, we're going to put Patrice Evra. And these inherently haven't busted up themselves, but there is a guy who goes in the middle of them who has, and that is Luis Suarez. I could have even put Ivanovic in here as well. I probably could have made a whole squad of people that Suarez has pissed off throughout his career. But we've just gone for these two for now. Two of the more high-profile ones, Chiellini, of course, being at the World Cup where Suarez bit him, which is absolutely just blows my mind, but we're not going to go into that in this video. I actually think Chiellini said he kind of forgiven him and hoped he didn't get banned for too long, but at the same time, come on, you've just fucking bit him. And then next to him, we've got Patrice Evra, who Suarez was, of course, banned for being racist to, and I'm pretty sure Evra still hates him, and they didn't shake hands or something like that. If I remember correctly, he just totally ignored them as they walked past the last time Liverpool played Man United when Suarez and Evra were playing for them. Next to them, we have got Rio Ferdinand. Now, this guy had a bust-up with John Terry, but that's not actually who's going to be in this squad next to him. John Terry, if I remember correctly, wasn't criminally punished in actual court, but I think he was banned for a couple of games and stripped of the England captaincy. That might be wrong. I'm not 100% sure about that, but it was a really long time ago and I didn't bother looking at it. But that incident was, he was defended, John Terry was, by Ashley Cole, who Rio Ferdinand went and then called a chalk ice, which I think is just absolutely hilarious, and that's why I went and put him. He was referring to Ashley Cole, which is kind of inherently racist itself, but it just does make me laugh a little bit. He said Ashley Cole is black on the outside, but white on the inside, because he stuck up for the white man instead of the black man. I don't know, it's pretty stupid and pretty funny. It just gives me a little chuckle. So that's why I put them to him, but they apparently have a massive falling out. And of course, they used to be England teammates, but they don't talk anymore because of that incident. As well, lads, very quickly, if you guys notice something a bit weird with my voice, I've got a very, very sore throat at the moment. So my ears and everything and my nose are all blocked up and stuff. I think I'm getting a bit of a cold. So I can't really hear if I sound any different myself. I think I just sound a bit weird because everything sounds a bit weird. But if my voice does sound a bit weird to you, then apologies. And hopefully it sounds better in my next few videos when I start to get better. But let's move on and take a look at Patrick Vieira and Roy Keane. These guys absolutely hated each other, like fought umpteen million times when they were playing for Arsenal and Manchester United. They were like contenders for the league, the two big clubs. And these were the two psychos that ran the midfield for them two big clubs. Absolutely unbelievable players. You can see they've both got legend cards and they're both rated the same. I wonder what they'd have to say about that themselves. They did actually do a documentary, so I don't want to go into too much detail about them because I would really, really recommend that you go and watch this. It's called Keane and Vieira, Best of Enemies. If you literally just Google that, you can find a link on Daily Motion where you can go and watch this. I've been watching it. I've watched like half of it just before making this video. I got distracted while I was looking about them. It is very good, very interesting. They're kind of best of enemies now and they're amicable and they'll talk and do interviews together and stuff like that. But they used to proper go at each other on the pitch. It was absolutely crazy. Next to them, we have got Joey Barton and Gervinho. Now, Gervinho got sent off in his very, very first game in English football. He made his debut starting for Arsenal, and he got sent off for a bust-up with Joey Barton. They've been going at it for the whole game. I don't actually think it was Gervinho who did what he got sent off for, which is crazy. They were fighting and having all sorts of back and forward, whatever you want to call it, scruffing and grabbing each other's shirts and getting in each other's face and doing the typical hard knock footballer thing where they just square up to each other and no one really does anything. And then Tom Straczynski came flying in and smashed Joey Barton with an elbow in the crowd. And Joey Barton hit the floor like a sack of shit because he's a big pussy. And he'll square up to everyone, but as soon as someone taps him on the face, He's down on the floor trying to get them sent off. And for some reason, the ref thought that it was Jovino and sent him off. And basically, these guys have just hated each other ever since. It was actually put forward by Joey Barton in an interview that he was going to sign for Arsenal when he had the bust up with the Newcastle manager and they wanted him gone. Wenger was talking to him and wanted to sign him, but he didn't sign because Jovino played for Arsenal and he hated Jovino, which I think is absolutely crazy. So apparently Joey Barton still carries a grudge towards Jovino to this day. Finally then, we've got one of the most high profile of these arch rival cases, and it's really, really famous. We have got Icardi and Maxi Lopez. I'm sure you guys know about this, or a lot of you guys will know about this, but I'm going to go through it very quickly. And everything that we know about it isn't 100% set in stone. It's a lot like gossip, and it's like the footballer version of a women's magazine, which is absolutely hilarious. But basically, Maxi Lopez has helped Icardi throughout his career. I think they used to play together at one of the clubs, and of course, they're both Argentinian. Maxi Lopez is a lot older than Icardi, and he's kind of helped him and brought him up through the ranks and stuff like that. And then Icardi ended up running off with Maxi Lopez's wife and getting his kids tattooed on him and all sorts of stuff like that. She was having an affair with the guy's wife. He ran off with her. He was started having to go with him on Twitter and all stuff like that. It's absolutely crazy, and they've had a big public falling out. A lot of it, again, is a little bit of gossip about what happens with the relationship, whether they were actually having an affair, whether they broke up first. I'm not too sure. I'm not really one to comment on it. But these guys absolutely hate each other in real life now, which I think is crazy. And kind of a bit weird from Icardi as well to just run off behind his back of some guy who's helped him throughout his whole career. And also, I don't know. It is absolutely mental. Like I said, it's kind of like a women's gossip column. I'm not really one to comment on it and start spreading all sorts of crazy stuff. But that is kind of the stuff that we do already know. So that is where we're going to leave this video, lads. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. Like I said, apologies if I sound a little bit funny. Hopefully I'll get better and I'll be able to make some normal videos for you guys soon, sounding as normal as I do normally anyway. But that is where we're going to leave it. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. As always, if you've got any more, pop them down in the comment sections, any ones that I missed out and could have popped in this squad. If you have enjoyed it, like I said, if again we could smash the 2,000 likes, if you want to see more of these videos, that would be absolutely awesome. Thanks for watching, lads. Make sure you hit that subscribe button as well if you are new around here, and stick around, and I will see you next time.